Family and friends, on behalf of Jessica and Mike, I'd just like to welcome you here to their very, very special day. We're just about ready to get started, so if all of you could just silence your cell phones to make sure that we have them all silenced, we'll get ready to go, okay? All right.
Thank you.
Would everyone please be seated? We are gathered here today in the sight of God in the presence of family and friends to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, to give recognition to the worth and beauty of love, and to add our best wishes and blessings to the words which shall unite Jessica and Michael in holy matrimony. Who is it that brings this woman to be united to this man?
Her mother and I.
Marriage is a most honorable estate, created and instituted by God, signifying unto us the mystical union which also rests between Christ and his church. So too may this marriage be adorned by true and abiding love. Jessica and Michael, life is given to each of us as individuals, and yet we must learn to live together. Love is given to us by our family and friends. We learn to love by being loved. Learning to love and living together is one of life's greatest challenges and is the shared goal of a married life. But a husband and wife should not confess love of worldly measures, or even if worldly success is found. Only love will maintain a marriage. Mankind did not create love. Love is created by God. The measure of true love is a love both freely given and freely accepted, just as God's love for us is unconditional and free. Today is a glorious day. The Lord is made. As today, both of you are blessed with God's greatest of all gifts, the gift of abiding love and the devotion between a man and a woman. All present here today and those here in heart wish both of you all the joy, all the happiness, and success that this world has to offer. As you travel through life together, I caution you to remember that the true measure of success, the true avenue of joy and peace, is to be found within the love you hold in your hearts. Within the Bible, nothing is of more importance than love. God is love. We are assured that love conquers all. It is love which brings you here today. The union of two hearts and two spirits. As your lives continue to grow as one, remember that it was love that brought you here today. It is love that will make this a glorious and happy marriage, and it is love which will cause this marriage to endure. Let us pray. God of all people, you are the true light that shines on everyone. You show us the way, the truth, and the life. You love us even when we are disobedient. You sustain us with the Holy Spirit. We rejoice in your life in the midst of our lives. We praise you for your presence with us, and especially in this act of solemn covenant, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Michael, do you take Jessica to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Repeat after me. I'm Michael.
I'm Michael.
Take you, Jessica.
Take you, Jessica.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
And my love from this day forward.
My love from this day forward.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
Our family and friends.
Our family and friends.
I offer you my solemn vow.
I offer you my solemn vow.
To be your faithful partner.
Be your faithful partner.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To honor.
To honor.
And respect you.
And respect you.
To laugh with you and cry with you.
To laugh with you and cry with you.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Jessica, do you take Michael to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
You have your name.
I, Jessica.
Take you, Michael.
Take you, Michael.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
And my love from this day forward.
And my love from this day forward.
In the presence of God. Our family and friends.
Our family and friends.
I offer you my solemn vow.
I offer you my solemn vow.
To be your faithful partner.
To be your faithful partner.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer.
For richer.
Or poorer.
Or poorer.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To honor and respect you.
To honor and respect you.
To laugh with you and cry with you.
To laugh with you and cry with you.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
I'd like to read from God's Word, 1 Corinthians 13, 4-7, and verse 13. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always preserves. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Amen. May I have the rings? Rings are the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to us the union between Jesus Christ and His church. Jessica, I give you this ring. That's it. Okay.
Jessica, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol for my love for you.
Let it be a reminder. That I am always by your side.
And I will love.
Honor.
And cherish you in all times.
In all places. And in all ways forever. Michael,
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love for you. Let it be a reminder. That I am always by your side. And I will love. Honor. And cherish you in all times. In all places. And in all ways forever. Michael and Jessica, as the two of you come into this marriage, united, you as husband and wife, and as you this day affirm your faith and love for one another, I would ask that you always remember to cherish each other as special and unique individuals. That you respect thoughts, ideas, and suggestions of one another. Be able to forgive. Do not hold grudges. And live each day that you may share it together. As from this day forward, you shall each be each other's home, comfort, and refuge. Your marriage strengthened by your love and by your respect. Michael and Jessica, in so much as the two of you have agreed to live together in matrimony, have promised your love for each other by these vows, the giving of these rings, and the joining of your hands. By the power vested in me by our God, the Universal Life Church, and the state of New Jersey, I now pronounce you husband and wife. May God the Eternal keep you in love with each other, so that the peace of Christ may abide in your home. Go to serve God and your neighbor in all that you do. Amen. You may kiss your bride. Present to you this newly married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Schlapp.